Balancing redox reaction by ion electron method or half reaction method. Let's take a look at this equation representing a chemical reaction. Figure the reducing and oxidizing agent. In ion electron method, one reaction is divided into two reactions, and then they are balanced and then added together. Identify the oxidation and reduction reactions. In this reaction, antimony has charge of plus 3 and is changing into plus 5. So antimony is being oxidized. Sulfur has charge of minus 2 and is changing into plus 6. So sulfur is being oxidized. Now we can write the two oxidation reactions in one equation. In this reaction, nitrogen has charge of plus 5 and it changing into plus 2. So nitrogen is being reduced. Now you can balance the number of atoms in the two half reactions. In the oxidation half reaction, to balance the sulfur atoms, we need to put a coefficient of 3 in front of HS44-. The sulfur atoms are balanced. Now we need to balance the oxygen atoms. To balance the oxygen atoms, you can produce the water molecules to another side. The oxygen atoms are balanced. Now you can balance the hydrogen atoms. To balance the hydrogen atoms, you can produce H+ ions to other side. The number of atoms in oxidation half reaction is balanced. For a redox reaction, the addition of charges on both sides should be equal. So try it in the oxidation half reaction. So both sides are not equal. To make them equal, you should add electrons as you can't add protons. Thus, if you think of adding 28 protons to left side to make it equal to 28, it is wrong. But you can add 28 electrons to right side to make it equal to 0. Make electron gain equivalent to the electron lost. The electron gained in the oxidation half reaction must be equal to the electron lost in the reduction half reaction. Now you can balance the number of atoms in the reduction half reaction. To balance the oxygen atoms, you can produce the water molecules to other side. The oxygen atoms are balanced. Now you can balance the hydrogen atoms. To balance that, you can produce H+ ions to other side. Now you can try to make the charges equal on both sides. To make them equal, you should add electrons. We need 28 electrons, not 3. So to get 28 electrons, you can multiply the equation by a coefficient of 28/3. Now you can add the both reactions. Now you can cancel the same terms. Now you can multiply the equation by a coefficient of 3 on both sides. Now you can cancel the same terms. The equation is now balanced. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press on the bell icon.